Good morning, everybody, and welcome to week 3 of this English course on Instagram. This morning, I want to talk about a verb that no one ever knows how to say. I don't know why. I am going to give you a few options. Number one, to yell at someone. Hey, don't yell at me. Number two, to scold. I should scold you for being late. Yeah. Three, to tell someone off. It's more informal, okay? My parents told me off for leaving a mess in my bedroom. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Irregular Tuesday. Today we're going to talk about a verb that is irregular, and it's got different meanings, really. Don't you want to come? No, that's not what I meant. Now, read the next examples and try to understand what is the Italian meaning of those sentences from the context, okay? I think it's pretty interesting how the verb to mean can mean different things depending on the context. It's also an adjective. Now, listen.
What do you mean? Oh, 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 when you nod your head yes, but you wanna say no, what do you mean?
Very practical exercise for you today. Think of a song that has the word mean in it. Comment under the post and tell me what the word mean means in that song, okay? Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Pronunciation Wednesday. Today I want you to read out loud, okay? Do it. How do you pronounce these two words? What do you think? Try. I don't know why, but most people are convinced, including my boyfriend, that this fruit is pronounced pear. Well, it's not. It's pear, okay? In English, there are many words that are called homophones. And basically, these words are written in different ways, okay? But they're pronounced the same. Here are more examples. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Grammar Thursday. Today I want to talk about present continuous or present progressive, as you wish. Yes, you might think that you already know everything about it, but maybe you don't. I have something that might be new for you. Let's see. Structure is really, really simple. So subject, verb to be, ing. So I am dancing, I am eating, I am drinking, and so on, all right? Very similar to Italian. I am talking right now for something that you are doing right now, okay? But listen to me. Marco is always leaving crumbs on the table. He's always listening to loud music and he's always tickling me. The present continuous can be used to describe annoying habits. Careful, annoying is a false friend. Annoying means this, okay? This is boring, okay? Of course, I still love him so much. Now it's your turn. Tag a person under the next post and describe his or her annoying habit. Good morning, everybody, and happy Friday. Today, I want to introduce an idiom, but first, I want you to try to guess from this picture. I cut my finger badly, but anyways, when you take something with a pinch of salt, it means that you don't really believe that, okay? And yeah. For example, I always take what my mom says with a pinch of salt because she tends to exaggerate. Love you, Mom. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to our Sunday quiz. As always, don't forget that you can revise all the things that we did on my highlighted stories, okay? Week 3. As I said yesterday, you can set a reminder every Sunday so that you don't miss the quiz because it only lasts 24 hours. So you can set it on your phone every Sunday around 11 or so, I don't know. Peer, peer. I am so sorry about the first question. I don't know what happened. But anyways, I hope you're happy with your result and I'll see you tomorrow for a completely new mini course. And if you liked it, please tell someone about this page. Bye.